Hey, welcome back to Ask Matt. So the question for today is actually not a question to me, but I got tagged in a response by James Mills. The original question was from Lynn Park, and Lynn asked, how do I ask senior devs to be meaner on code reviews, like please shame my PR? And James said, I'd flat out ask your senior devs. I'm not sure you'd really want meaner code reviews. Maybe ask them how they would have it done, or how they would have done it, or ask them to help you refactor what you've done. I bet Matt Stauffer has some good ideas on this. Maybe he'll do video on the question. So, Lynn, even though you didn't ask me, James did, so I'm going to go for it. So, I mean, I think the first thing to do would definitely just be say, hey, be meaner. And they may ask the question of, well, what does meaner actually mean for you? And then you can talk about that a little bit. But I think that when someone says, I want someone to be meaner, or please shame my PR, what they mean is they feel like they're not getting valuable feedback. And that's a super important thing to be aware of and to acknowledge that I need, in order for myself to grow, to get more concrete and direct confrontation in order for me to get the things I want, in order to grow or whatever. As I'll actually speak a little bit to the seniors in the situation, and let's assume that they know all this already. But because I don't know, that's the easiest way for me to speak, is it can be really hard to give critical feedback in a way that feels positive and caring. And so one of the things that can lead us to do is to withhold the critical feedback out of the fear of offending someone. So one of the first things that happens when somebody starts working at Titan is they have this kind of like sort of notorious like first code review from Matt, because I have a reputation of being like a really nice guy on the internet. And so people expect that I will never say anything that will make them uncomfortable working at the company. And you get your first code review from me, and it's extremely direct and frank. Every single thing that I don't like about it, I'm going to put a note about it. Now, that doesn't mean I'm not going to do it kindly. You know, and I, of course, Lynn saying, please shame my PR is like, you know, that's a little bit of a joke about it. But like, it feels strong enough of a confrontation, literally just saying you did this wrong, that that already accomplishes this goal. Like, please shame my PR. Well, saying everything's wrong is going to be enough. You don't have to be mean about it. So when Lynn says mean, I'm pretty sure what she means is, like, don't hold back. Like, don't hold back on giving me the information I need in order to figure out what I did wrong so I can do better. And I think that's the important thing is, like, there's a book called Radical Candor. I don't know if I subscribe to everything in it, but I do know that I read an article about it a while before the book came out that seemed to really resonate with how we try to do things at Titan. I am a naturally conflict avoidant person, which means it's uncomfortable for me to end up asking these questions or having these conversations in which I'm directly conflicting with somebody and confronting them and criticizing them. So it's in my nature to see something wrong and try to get around it. You know, it's not in my nature to see something wrong and to have a confrontation about it. And through some relationships I've been lucky to be a part of over the last, you know, 10, 15 years of my life, I've had interactions with people who are less conflict avoidant than me. And I've learned that there's so much value in the willingness to just have that conflict and recognize that conflict is not bad. Bad conflict is bad, but conflict inherently is not a bad thing. And leaving a critical code review can feel like conflict. And so it's something that we can often avoid out of fear for creating conflict or making ourselves uncomfortable or making somebody else uncomfortable. And so what is really valuable is just to recognize that, like, it's okay to say somebody did something wrong. And honestly, it's even better for them if you say it as early as possible. One of the things I learned from my friends and family who are not conflict avoidant is that one of the problems of being conflict avoidant is that you swallow the conflict and you swallow the conflict, you swallow the conflict, and then you blow up. And with folks for whom conflict is more comfortable, you have a small conflict and then it's done. And you have a small conflict and it's done. And you have a small conflict and it's done. And so that's what I've been growing in over the last 10, 15 years of my life. And I think it's really good for anybody who reviews code to learn, or supervises other people, or who are trying to teach other people, or anything else really, to learn how to have small conflicts and to not treat those as problems. And just to say, yeah, I'm going to tell you that this thing should have been done differently, and then you won't do it again. And I just kind of provided a service to you, and you can I can communicate it in a respectful and kind way, and you can give me the benefit of the doubt that I'm not doing it just to be mean. But in the end, I will have to have this conflicting thing, or else I'm basically keeping you from growing. And we have the same problem with a lot of situations with our employees where it's not code related, where something's wrong and we say we need to bring this thing up immediately. Otherwise, we're sitting here being like, oh yeah, you know, that person has a problem with that thing, but we're not going to tell them because that'd be conflict. So now we're just sitting here feeling like they're not doing a good job without giving them the opportunity to improve on it. So caring for someone else requires a level of willingness to have those little conflicts that for some of us is outside of our comfort zone. That's not true for everybody. Some people need to have less conflict. I don't know. But for a lot of us, it's outside of our comfort zone. And growing to be willing to have small, peaceful conflicts without it feeling like it's the end of the world is important for us to be a good friend, a good coworker, a good senior, a good leader, a good boss, or whatever else. So I hope this helps. I know Lynn didn't ask for it, but James or Lynn or anybody else who sees this, I hope this helps. As always, send me your questions in the comments on YouTube or on Twitter at Stauffer Matt or whatever else. See you next time.